After School Special Podcast. After School Special Podcast. After School Special Podcast. After School Special Podcast.
Winter is coming, 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 coming.
We are announcing some major changes today, moving forward, working to get even better at what we do. So you might have been reading about all the speculation. We thought today would be a good day to hear it from the horse's mouth.
It's typical to hear people talk about change, too. Change is everywhere and is a natural part of life.
And winter is coming!
Young man.
Winter is coming.
That's cold.
We need a call line. I've seen some podcasts have call lines. Would you guys call?
I think we would have some friends that would call in, and I would love that because
one person
in particular that would do that. And Tom on the town, I always mention him because he is one of my favorite people on the face of the planet. And he's very super supportive.
And we always get love from Doom Generation Podcast, Detroit Land Bending. They always give us love. And we try to reciprocate
that
love.
Quad Pro Quo Podcast as well.
Quad Pro Quo. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then it's Caitlin Noel Art. So we appreciate the people that are listening, the people that do support us. It does mean a hell fucking stupid Lord of the Rings bullshit. It just started playing. I'm like trying to find... I want to make sure that I'm like,
is that show good?
It's really good, man.
Is okay.
I stopped watching after episode 2 for a second, and then I caught up and got back on episode 5, and I'm fucking hooked.
House of the Dragon or that?
That. Over Lord of the Rings. I don't care about House of the Dragon.
Oh, you slut. Come on, man.
Dude, they did that
House of the
fucking,
Dragon
like,
is fucking
change.
Awesome.
I like Matt Smith. I love Matt Smith. I think
he's got a weird fucking face, but I like him.
Yeah. Well, I was used to the face mainly because of Doctor Who. But yeah, Matt Smith is
I know he's from there. I saw Morbius for the first time last week.
And you said it was a good movie.
I did not say it was a good movie. Shut up. You will not misquote me.
You did. I'll look at the text again. It was like,
white people always twisting my words.
Oscar worthy. It's Morbin time, everyone. It is Morbin time up in here is what you said verbatim. And that you would suck Jared Leto's dick.
Well, maybe. You know, that motherfucker is 50 years old. I had no idea. And I looked at my wife and was like, yeah.
He's got a cult.
I hit that. What?
Jared Leto's got a cult.
He deserves it. Look at him.
Well, we don't deserve a cult. Look at this. Look at us, these fine specimens.
I don't know, man. You
Sorry, I had something caught in my throat.
You cut off your coat beard. I don't know, man.
My coat. Well, you said my coke beard?
Sorry, that was my lips in my way. Your cult beard. You know, all the cult leaders have this strange...
Oh, cult. Cult. I thought you said coat.
I'm probably saying coat. I don't know.
I was going to say, like, I love true crime stuff. You and I both love true crime stuff.
Yeah,
but the
it.
Documentaries and the interest, it, like, how deep it goes into it and new information. The guy that does O.J. Simpson, you know, like the O.J. Simpson one, the Bill Clinton one, the Menendez brothers. He does American Horror Story.
Yes. I didn't know he did the other ones. So that's
Yeah. Well, I think he does, or
sounds
at least there's
right.
One other person that does it. But he brings on the same people, like Sarah Paulson. But I watched it, and I'm just like, I can't get into this guy as Dahmer. I couldn't. I just think of him as Quicksilver.
Oh, he's done so many roles that I kind of like put that in the pocket somewhere. I totally forgot about that.
See, but like I didn't watch American Horror Story. I didn't watch any of that other stuff with him. And so it's okay. I already knew the story. I knew everything like going into this about Dahmer and whatnot. And that were they really going to do this? Were they going to do it the way that I thought they were, which is kind of make him seem sympathetic, which is what people always fucking do.
I had that same reservation. I was shaking my head watching it the first 3 episodes. Mm-hmm. And then as it went on, I'm on episode 7. And I'm like, oh, they're not glorifying him like I thought. If anything, if you continue to watch, they highlight the privilege of this man. The unearned privilege of just being a tall white man in the 80s and going through the judicial system attacking minorities, or and they just let him go because it's like, eh, you know,
this is black people and it's in, you know, young, what is it, young gay black men in,
and some Asians,
an urban
and
area.
Some white,
yeah,
and some, it's,
oh,
some,
yeah, yep.
But like, that's why I said he's a, I jokingly say he's a Jordan of just the molesting people. Or not, well, yeah, cannibalism and everything. But yeah, it highlights that. It doesn't like make him seem like a superhero. Okay. It doesn't make him seem like Dexter. Because I was about to turn this shit off. As good as this guy is doing, I'm like, what the fuck am I doing here? Why am I watching this? And then it was like, oh, they're showing how corrupt the system is. At one point, not to spoil it for people, he just murders a guy in his house, and it's like one of his first murders. He chops him up, puts him in a garbage bags, and then he drives drunk. He's drinking, and the cop stops him, and they can smell the alcohol on him. They ask him what's in the garbage bag. He gives this flimsy excuse, and they just say, you're 18 years old. You got your whole life in front of you. I'm not going to ruin it. But take your fucking ass home. I'm like, what? What? I know they're dramatizing this. Maybe that didn't exactly happen that way. But if it did, it's like,
oh, dude,
are you serious?
My dad talked to me about that stuff. It's like, you could drive drunk. They wouldn't do anything to you. Yeah, dad, if you're white, you're fucking driving around. Ah, Larry, what are you doing out here, man? Oh, you old so-and-so. Oh, why did you get home, you fucking idiot?
Oh, Jeff, go ahead. Go have a few brewskis on the way back home. I'm like,
oh, there you go.
The guy's fucking still drunk. What?
Exactly. And then they go, hey, Darrell. Bam, bam. And it's just like, what the fuck?
He twitched at me. No, that was after you shot him. But
yeah, exactly.
But nah, the show is actually better than I thought it was going to be, because I had low expectations. Not because of the director. It was just, if you ever watch American Horror Story anthology, he somewhat glorifies serial killers on there, and you know, it's way over the top.
Yeah.
So I thought this was going to be the same thing. If anything, it's the opposite. I give him credit. This guy should probably win an award. I don't say
it's
that.
It's actually a lot of people aren't digging it right now.
Which is, I mean, man, that's the story of me.
The LGBTQ community, when it first started, it had that LGBTQ thing like tag on it, which I'm like, it's Jeffrey Dahmer.
Yeah, what?
What the fuck is, what the hell is wrong with you, Netflix?
One of the criticisms,
and they finally took it down.
Yeah, one of the criticisms were the surviving victims of the families should receive some compensation from this whole series. Like,
yeah,
I'm for it, and a lot of them criticized them for not being involved, criticizing that the victims that are shown in this show, they're basically nameless, faceless, like, oh, he murders this person, but more about Dahmer, like, what about his life? And I agree with that, but at the same time, I don't think they're glorifying him. I don't even think, it's not even like a, hey, this is how you make a serial killer. He was born this way, his dad beat him, his mom hated him. It's not really like that. It was more so like, no, this guy is just, he's just fucked up, man. He had factors that went against him, but he had privileges that a lot of people that he killed never had.
Yep.
And he still chose to do this. Now, his mom took antidepressants when she was having him, when he was still in her womb. And she was psychologically just not there because she was going through postpartum depression? Or
postpartum depression. I thought there was some schizophrenia in there.
That too. That too. But
the other thing, just to bring up, which I don't even think they mentioned in the movie, or the show, the hernia operation that he got when he was younger. This is something that was brought up. The fact that
they did bring it up.
They did. Okay.
They didn't show it, but they brought. He said, his character said, yeah, I had a hernia operation when I was a kid, and it didn't go right, and I was just never the same after that. And I was like, what the fuck does that got to do with anything? But
so it was brought up. He never actually said anything about it. He had said it to someone, I guess, in a sense, but it wasn't like, I thought it was his dad that had said it, that he wasn't the same after that.
Oh, maybe it was his dad. Maybe it was his dad. Maybe it was.
Hey, babies, you liking the show? Well, thanks. Leave a 5-star rating and a comment, please. Do you want to see the guys' faces? Well, they got YouTube videos. It comes out every Wednesday before the episode comes out on Friday. You can watch this podcast on any major platform you listen to. Rate 5 stars and comment. Thanks, babies.
But yeah, okay. So going from cults to Dahmer, just to tell you guys a little bit about what's going on. John left the show.
Ah, spoiler alert.
Well, he's taking a little bit of a hiatus, everyone.
Yeah, he's dead. No, I'm kidding.
we Dahmered him. I was going to say, John's taking a little bit of a hiatus. Hopefully he will be back, but right now it is just Don and I. Sans the staff man, who was the big dick of the group. Staff man.
John, staff man will be back. You know, it's one of those things, man. But as far as the show goes, you're going to get more shit, more jokes, more laughs, more, you know,
offensive shit.
Yeah, basically. Staff man, who basically was the mature one of this group.
Yeah, he was the moral, I'm trying to think. He had the moral reasoning, or the, what's the word I'm looking for? He was the saint out of all of us.
He was the adult.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, so there now,
it's just, he's gone. The filter's gone.
Oh, the fucking filter's gone. You're going to get shit that you didn't even think you wanted to hear. Honestly, quite frankly, shit that you didn't even ask for. So you're welcome. More skits, more dumb shit. We're going to be flying and bouncing around. It's going to be fucking great.
I think, audience members, we looked at this as like a business. The fact that I said earlier in the beginning that we hate our jobs. And we wanted something more. We wanted to make this into a business. And now we're at the point where, you know, our dreams are dashed more or less because no one listens except for a average 30 people, which, hey, you 30 out there, you're fucking great. And we love you, and you get us. You get our humor. And we appreciate that because a lot of people don't get our humor. A lot of people look at us in disgust and usually fart, flutter their hand, and then walk away as we, I guess, are on our knees and just having to waft it in our face. You know, that's what we are. We're the ones that get on our knees and smell farts.
Yeah. Sometimes we take it on the chest. Sometimes we take it on the chin.
Are we talking about farts?
Huh? Oh, what are we talking about again? I'm sorry. I wasn't listening. As far as, like, things that we're going to talk about, it's basically going to be the same shit. Talking about nostalgia, we're talking about farts, we're talking about white castles, we're talking about just dumb shit.
We just want to have fun. I think that's where we kind of got away from it.
Yeah.
Was, you know, like, we tried to definitely, and, you know, if you don't like it, well, I don't know.
Suck a dick. No, I don't know. What's the gender neutral term for dick?
General neutral term? There is no, I guess it would be, flat.
So you searched your brain and you came up with that. Well, I mean,
flat. Suck my flat.
Yeah, suck a flat.
Well, to be honest, we're not gonna, you don't have to suck a flat, but the thing is that we just don't have, we want to put out content, but we want to put out stuff that we think is funny, and if other people think it's funny, damn, that would be nice. If not, I don't know, suck, we're just gonna talk about Minions After School Special Podcast, Minions Podcast, solely talking about the Minions and their leader Gru. Despicable Me and 2 and 3.
Or the new Daredevil movie. Oh my god, I blew it. That's what she said.
Why'd you blow it?
I meant Deadpool. God damn it.
Daredevil. Yeah, I'm like, what the,
oh, Daredevil. No, there is going to be a new Daredevil. That's true. I forgot about that. No, I meant Deadpool. Deadpool 3. I know Staff Man, he texted us up that clip of Deadpool coming back with Wolverine. That kind of pissed me off. I didn't like that.
Oh, yeah. Well, you want the real, like, fucking Berserker Rage Wolverine.
I want the Wolverine that we were left with in, what, 2000?
Logan.
Yeah, Logan. Oh, man. Yeah, yeah.
12. Well, the whole thing is that Marvel now is just a fucking joke. Like, and not,
whoa,
I'm
whoa,
not gonna
I didn't
say
all
about
that now.
Well, everything's got to have a funny little twist to it. Nothing can be serious. Whereas, like, you have Winter Soldier. Fuck, dude. Winter Soldier was serious. You had, like, a funny part here and there, but it wasn't, like, all Liffy Laffy or whatnot. And then, like, Doctor Strange. Yeah, there were some, but there were a lot of, like, parts where, well, no. I did like Doctor Strange. That was more like a horror film. It was Sam Raimi, so it's like, yeah. But then, you know, She-Hulk, I love the character She-Hulk. I love the person that plays her. I think she does a really good job. I think it's a shitty script, plain and simple. She got handed a shitty fucking script. And I do hope that they do a TV show, The Heroes for Hire, because She-Hulk will be in it, Daredevil.
Luke Cage.
Jessica hopefully Jones, a new maybe. Iron Fist. Yeah, Jessica Jones, maybe. I wonder if they'll take a different route with that, because they're, you know, with Daredevil, they're doing the yellow and the red to start off. Same look to the costume, but yellow and red. He's going to be showing up in She-Hulk at one of these episodes anyways. They had the mid-season preview, and there's a scene where She-Hulk is in her costume, which is the purple, the white spandex suit.
Ooh. Yep. I didn't think they were going to do that for 2022. I thought that was like too risque or...
Well, they could have done the... She would wear a black tank top. I was going to say white... beater, but I that's not a good term.
Oh, what's a better 2022
tank top?
Oh, that's not fun. I like wife beater. Can we just call them husband beaters?
We'll call them husband beaters. There man beaters, huh? Fuck the patriarchy.
What man beaters? Yeah, damn. But no, I even saw that Miss Marvel one. Did you see that? That was pretty good.
Yeah, I thought it was good.
Very good. And then they introduce, spoiler alert, the whole mutant thing at the end. I was like, okay.
Yeah, I didn't really like that.
It was a little cheap. So, it was a little cheap. Yeah. I'll take it. Because
there's
had
something in your DNA.
A mutation?
There's something in your DNA.
But they put the X-Men, that little theme song, and I was like, hell yeah.
Oh, yeah.
It was like 3 seconds. So I was like, oh, so this is how they're going to do it. They're going to do it with the Miss Marvel thing, and then they're going to do the Deadpool thing, and then they're going to do probably the next Avengers going to start phasing it in.
Milking it. Milking it.
Woo!
Yeah, no, I would think so. They're not going to do like a X-Men movie right away. Mutants are probably going to be after these next, the whole Kang thing, which I hope they introduce Dr. Doom. I hope he's the main villain. That's what I'm hoping for.
It looked too big. I don't know, man. It's a lot going on.
I can't remember the place that he lives, but they did it in Moon Knight. It looked like...
Shit.
It's not Latvia. It's something with a Via. It's some, like, Russian Euro place. I can't remember, but it's, like, his castle. Whatnot.
Leviathan.
And they thought... Leviathan? Leviathan?
That's not a word.
It's a monster. It's a monster of Greek origin, I think. The Leviathan.
Dr. Doom's... Like, what was the shit?
Dr. Doom's
home.
Where does Dr. Yeah, there you go.
He lives in Latveria. Latveria?
Latveria. Okay, yeah.
Yeah.
We'll just say Latvia.
Right.
Hey guys, if you like to see us in the flesh, we have video highlights of our episodes we release on every Wednesday before the new episode that comes out Friday. As always, you can catch this podcast on any major platform you listen to podcasts. Please make sure to rate us 5 stars and comment on how you're liking the show.
After School Special Podcast.
It's this lady and she's like, hi, welcome to my vagina.
After School Special Podcast.
What robot pet starts out speaking a unique language but eventually speaks English? Gloopy? The fuck is a gloopy?
Podcast comes out every Friday.
But to go back real quick, yeah, we're going to try to change this up a little bit. And if you guys like it, cool. Tell us what you want to hear. We want to entertain you. Let us entertain you. At the same time, we make fun of everyone and everything. The rules and regulations, the cancel culture, the racism and bigotry that happens, all needs to be made fun of, and people need to be knocked down a peg or four, as far as I'm concerned. And that's what it's going to be about. Not only talking about ourselves within our past, because this is a nostalgia podcast. This is talking about our past. This is talking about movies that we watched, memories that we had with friends, loved ones. In reality, that's all life is, and that's what makes life worth living, are the memories, are the relationships that we have with people, are the relationships that we have with you, the listener. Tell us what you want to hear. Tell us what you want to do. Don't say another word. Hush. And we'll see you next time at After School Special Podcast. Bitches.
Hey everyone, it's Aaron from After School Special Podcast. Like what you hear so far? But don't forget to subscribe and download the show on whatever platform you get your podcasts. And just a friendly reminder, we have new episodes out every Friday. Thanks for listening, everyone.
Fucking stupid Lord of the Rings.